And of course, the reason I really like Chrisfield and the reason I'm still here is because it's home. Even though it floods sometime, it's still home. So it's about 8 miles from here to Smith Island. It's almost 30 miles across the bay here. So yeah, waves get pretty high here. That's a problem.
I'm Jackie Specht. I'm the Resilient Coast Program Director with the Nature Conservancy. We're working with George Mason University and the Maryland Department of Natural Resources to assess the wave attenuation benefits of coastal habitats across Maryland. And we're doing this through a hydrodynamic model that we're updating with sea level rise projections. With climate change, we're expecting to see more frequent and more intense storms. And as we've seen with previous work that we've done with the Maryland Department of Natural Resources and George Mason University, our coastal habitats can provide really important benefits for reducing wave energy from storms. We did a study that showed that the first few feet of tidal marsh can actually reduce wave energy by 90%. So we really want to make sure that we're doing work that is helping us conserve our coastal habitats like marshes so that they can continue to provide those important benefits in the future.
Our lab has been studying coastal flooding and adaptation solutions in the Chesapeake Bay for the last 10 years. Most importantly, in this project, we're studying flood protection and the ability of this ecosystems to attenuate storm surges and waves during storms. The way we do that is we place sensors that are able to measure wave energy across these habitats, all the way from the near shore throughout these habitats, and we're able to very precisely and accurately measure wave energy as it propagates through these habitats. And in fact, for this project, we are running scenarios all the way to 2100, in which we have different sea level rise scenarios for the entire state of Maryland, and we're specifically focusing on wave attenuation and coastal flood protection into the future. So we're really trying to have a look into the future with the tools that we have today on how these ecosystems will be providing coastal protection into the future.
So in Maryland, we have a number of different coastal habitats, but the ones that provide the most coastal protection benefit are our tidal wetlands, as well as our forests, our seagrass beds, and our oyster reefs. So in this project, we're studying a number of different coastal habitats, specifically tidal wetlands and seagrass beds, but we're also looking at how different types of living shorelines can provide protection benefits for communities. The data collected from this study will help us make better decisions about where to restore and protect our coastal habitats and make decisions about different types of coastal restoration strategies. For example, we want to better understand how wide a marsh needs to be in order to provide coastal protection benefits, and this study will provide us with that type of information. The data collected from this study will also serve as valuable inputs into statewide models that help us better understand how coastal habitats will transition over time as sea levels rise. And as we spread this information throughout the state, we can work with communities to make decisions about where they want to implement these types of practices.
We have currently across from us over here is the James Island State Park, and that's a little over 3,000 acres protected but usable. We can fish in it, we can hunt in it, we can walk the beaches and swim and whatever we want to do. So we really like that, and also it shows that our community is really oriented to preserving nature and taking care of things.
The study is giving us the information that we need in order to understand where habitats across Maryland are providing benefits like reducing storm energy, so that partners like the state can direct their conservation efforts to locations on the ground that are going to have the biggest impact for protecting coastal communities and preserving important coastal habitat.